complexity theory. Okay, here I will first discuss different classes of problems and then I will go into the complexity theory in detail. Okay, so first is tractable and intractable problems. Okay, so tractable problems are called easy problems and intractable problems are hard problems. Okay, so easy problem means if there exists a polynomial algorithm or if there exists an efficient algorithm to solve that problem in a polynomial time, then that kind of problem is called a tractable problem. And in the case of intractable problem, there is no efficient algorithm to solve that problem in polynomial time. Okay, so for an example, the merge sort, matrix multiplications and all other algorithms which have complexity of polynomial is called their complexity will be like n raised to k log n or something like that. That kind of algorithms are called tractable problems or algorithms or tractable problems. Okay, the problem traveling salesman problem and 0-1 XR problem, all these algorithms have a complexity not in polynomial time, because in the case of traveling salesman problem, the complexity is n square into 2 raised to n, something like that. Okay, so the complexity is not a polynomial. So this kind of algorithms are called or problems are called intractable problems. Okay, so the problems which have a efficient algorithm to solve them in polynomial time, that is the complexity algorithm is polynomial, then that problems are called tractable problems. Okay, now there are two classes of algorithms, deterministic and non-deterministic algorithms. Okay, in deterministic algorithm, result of every operation is uniquely defined, that is there is no choice. Okay, I hope you remember the deterministic automata and a non-deterministic automata. Okay, in the case of non-determinism, there will be a choice, that is result of every operation is not uniquely defined and there will be a choice for next step. Okay, and in the case of deterministic algorithm, there will not be any choice. All the algorithms that we are using in the real world are deterministic algorithms. Okay, the computer cannot choose like human beings. Okay, everything will be clearly defined. Okay, but non-deterministic algorithms we are using them for research purposes. Okay, for example, you consider this algorithm. This is a search algorithm, and we know the best search algorithm is binary search and its complexity is around log n. But here I am proposing a search algorithm that can do search operation in order of one time. Okay, that is constant time. Okay, so for that I am taking the input x, the element to be searched as input, then an array of element of size n. Okay, then I am using a procedure called a choice. Okay, and I am passing the index of 1 to n to that procedure and it will return j. Okay, and I am saying that this choice procedure will return the index of the element to be searched. Okay, and I check if a of j is equal to x, then I will write j and I will call another procedure called success. And if a of j not equal to x, then I will write 0 and call a procedure called failure. Okay, so the choice procedure will return the correct index of the element to be searched. How the choice procedure works, I don't know. Okay, so I am saying that if you want to develop a algorithm, search algorithm that have a complexity order of 1, then you have to develop a procedure called choice that will return the index of the element in order of 1 time. Okay, but how that choice is working, I don't know now. Okay, so here I am proposing. Okay, for this purpose, if you are using a very big algorithm, some procedure will take a non-polynomial time. Okay, so you can create some kind of sub procedures and you can say if this procedure will return value in an order of one time, then we can solve this algorithm in a polynomial time or like that. Okay, so choice function is arbitrarily choose one of the element from a set, and the success function will call on successful termination of the algorithm, and failure function will call on unsuccessful termination of the algorithm. Okay, so I hope you understood what is non-deterministic algorithm. That is, we don't know what is happening inside algorithm. We will use a choice function and it will return the correct value, but we don't know what it is now. Okay, so we will say it is non-deterministic now. You have to find out a deterministic version of this.